Welcome to Emacs 2. My name is Luis Shell. In this video, we are going to take a look at the Zoom H4n Pro. You've been making video on YouTube for a while now, and you've been using your DSLR to record sound, and people have been yelling at you that the sound is no good because the preamp on your DSLR are not suitable to record sound. This is exactly why the sound is no good. And you finally purchase your Zoom H4n Pro, H4n, H5 or H6. But on this video, we are gonna take a good look at how to record your first sound on the Zoom H4n Pro. What you're looking at right now is the Zoom H4n Pro, and it is nothing short of a mobile portable studio in the palm of my hands. And we're just gonna take a look around different buttons. The first one we're gonna take a look at is where you suppose to monitor your sound. You just need a 2.5 millimeter jack to plug your headset so you can monitor the sound. And on top is basically a remote where you can plug the remote and control the Zoom H4n from a distance. And we're not gonna talk too much about it. This right here is your volume level where you have the plus and minus. And this is where you plug your USB to plug it to your computer, because the Zoom H4n can be used as your sound card. And on the bottom of it, this is your power button. And on top, this is your scrolling wheel. The scrolling wheel is also the same button you will push in when you're not scroll, so you can select the different option on your Zoom H4n. And on the bottom of it is the menu button. And right here is the recording level button. Let's say you're booming an interview. You have the option to switch mic from a person to a different one, and different person have different volume or they speak with. You're probably gonna have to keep on either volume up or volume down, so you can keep the level stable for both speaker. And on the bottom of that, this is where you will find your SD card, where to place your SD card, because it's important to have an SD card to record your sound. And this is your record button, and you can see stop and play. And on top, we have the different input of that Zoom H4n Pro. And I also have to tell you that in the back, we have another mode called the stamina mode. That is not that important, because we aren't going to stay on the stamina mode today, because it's basically the same as the stereo mode. And one thing I believe that worth to notice is those lock they add on the bottom of the input of the Zoom H4n Pro that make it pretty solid if somebody by mistake trip on your wires, so it doesn't pull and disconnect your mic from the Zoom H4n Pro. The Zoom H4n Pro has a nice rubber that make it feel pretty good in the hand. That is one difference between the Zoom H4n Pro and the Zoom H4n. And also the light on the Zoom H4n Pro is blue, and on the H4n the light is kind of orange. Now let's not waste any more time. Let's go ahead. We're gonna turn on the Zoom H4n so we can start setting up. As you can see, this is the power. You just have to basically pull it down and hold it for a few seconds. Yes, I'm sure they do that on purpose so you do not turn off the Zoom H4n on by mistake. And after you turn the Zoom H4n on, as you can see, nothing move. The next thing to do is to basically format your SD card. And to do that, you go on the side, as you can see on the menu, you push menu, and you're gonna scroll down with that scroll button to the SD card. And when you reach SD card, we're gonna go ahead and do that. When we reach SD card, we're just gonna go ahead and press on the scrolling wheel to select that. And when we get that, it's gonna ask you, what do you want to do? Do you want to format? You go ahead and select format and push that scrolling wheel button again in, so you can make your selection. And as a safety question, it will ask you, are you sure? Do you want to? Yes. Do you want to do that? You go ahead and scroll on yes and push the button down, and your SD card will take a few minutes to format. And there we have it. The SD card is formatted. It's basically important to format this SD card, because sometimes people have problem with their Zoom H4N or H4N port not working because they did not do that. And basically the next thing to do is to set up your date and time. To do that, you go back to the menu again and scroll down to system. You push the menu button and you scroll down to system because it's important to set up date and time, because sometimes your file can be all over, but if you make a recording a certain time, you will be able to find it. When you click system and there and go, the first option will be your date and time. Mine, I already set up the date and time. I would not do it this time because it's already there. So you just go ahead and basically select each your a day, the date, the year, and you basically change them to make sure that your file will be saved. And if you are looking for them, you can easily find them because you set the date and time of your Zoom H4N. Before we go ahead and start, the main purpose of that video is to show you how to record your first sound. It's also important to know the different mode on your H4N, and as you can see, if you look at the front of it, you have a stereo mode. What is it exactly? What can you record with that stereo mode? You can basically you can record live band performances, acoustic instrument, voice. Also, you can do YouTube video, record YouTube video sound for your on your H4N Pro using the stereo mode. There's a four CH mode, basically four channel mode. You can record two stereo signal at the same time. Basically, you can capture live sound via the built-in mic that basically on top, those two mic that are on top of the H4N Pro, and you can use one of the input on the bottom of the microphone to record either a piano or a guitar. At the same time, you record the voice. As you can see, those are the bottom of it. And we have an MTR mode. It's most likely used to create sound effect. You can also use MTR mode to overdub recording. It is a very important. And as you know, in the back, we have the stamina mode. That's basically the same as the stereo mode. The stamina mode, they are basically the same, but when you put it on stamina, you have option to save the battery life on the stamina mode because it eat up the battery less on the stamina mode. But however, you will have less option when you use the stamina mode. Finally, we get to the point where we're gonna record our first sound on the Zoom H4N Pro, and we're gonna record on the stereo mode. And to do that, we're gonna press menu and we're gonna scroll down to mode. You have to be careful not to confuse mode with play mode. And after you select the stereo mode, you're gonna see the light on top of the stereo is lit. So that means we're on stereo mode. And as you can see on the bottom, before I press button on the middle, we have the first button lit. That means we are using the mic on top. And when the two other one lit, that means we are using the mic on the bottom. And when we push the record first time, it's just flashing. You can either press play to start recording or press record again. And this is how you record your sound in stereo mode. And remember, if you are using the other mode, you just go ahead and do the same thing. You go press menu and you scroll down to mode, and you're gonna select either a four channel or MTR to record on this mode. Thank you for watching. I hope this video was helpful to you. We took a good look at the Zoom H4N Pro, and like we said, the Zoom H5 and H6. The preamp on the H5 and the H6 is basically the same as the Zoom H4N Pro. Basically, that's gonna give you a lower noise floor when you record from your Zoom H4N Pro, because the Zoom H5 and H6 are a little bit more expensive. But however, the Zoom H4N Pro is pretty good. If you have one, you don't have to look into buy the upper model, because they can't give you quality sound. Like I said before, I hope this video was helpful to you, and if it was, give it a thumbs up. And if you have not been subscribed to our channel, we would love to have you as a subscriber. Go ahead, hit the subscribe button, subscribe to the channel so you do not miss on our latest video. And as always, I will catch you on the next video.